Hi, and welcome to this edition of Bobcat Update. I'm LaShan Randall.
And I'm Michael Ellis. Today, we'll tell you why the family of a student is suing the university, and we'll tell you what help there is for you when you can't sleep. Police say a murder suspect has admitted to killing his half-sister. According to the San Marcos Daily Record, Rigoberto Cordova Torres has admitted to stabbing 14-year-old Rosalia Arias to death. Police say the 19-year-old suspect was transferred to the Hays County Jail from Brackenridge Hospital on Monday and made a detailed confession. Police say Cordova Torres was at Brackenridge for treatment of an undisclosed medical condition. Cordova Torres' murder charge is a first-degree felony and carries a maximum sentence of life in prison.
Some Texas State students are winding down their efforts to help save lives. Kristen Orler has more in this Bobcat Update.
The Student Volunteer Connection is working hard on its five-day campaign to tackle hunger and homelessness. The organization started the week off Monday with the Oxfam Hunger Banquet, followed by a food drive and a bake sale.
Tomorrow, Friday, we're going to be having a Thanksgiving dinner at the San Marcos Activity Center, and over 800 families are going to be fed, so they're going to need lots of help with that. So we'll be out there from 5 to 9.
The events aim to provide meals for the underprivileged and to spread awareness for their situation. Hunger and Homelessness Week attempts to disprove that smaller cities like San Marcos do not have people going hungry. The homeless are not on the corners like they are in Austin, but that doesn't mean they don't exist. The Hays County Area Food Bank is working with Texas State to help the event.
We pick up on the average of a weekly basis about 5,000 to 6,000 pounds of food each week. We service approximately 1,000 families a week as well. That keeps us relatively busy, as you can see with that.
The SVC is asking volunteers to skip a meal today in remembrance of the millions of poor people in the world. The hope is that people will donate the money saved by skipping their meal to Oxfam.
The National Homeless and Hunger Week ends tomorrow. If you haven't dropped off your donations, you can do so here at the Hays County Area Food Bank. For Bobcat Update, I'm Kristen Euler.
The family of a Texas State student has filed a wrongful death suit against the university and Landry's Restaurants. According to the San Marcos Daily Record, Jason Lee Bonin drowned when he jumped off the balcony of Joe's Crab Shack into the Spring Lake Dam back in April. Now his father is claiming that the university and the restaurant were negligent. He says the university failed to make and keep the area safe for swimming. He also says the restaurant should have discouraged the tradition of employees jumping from the balcony. City officials say they recommend swimming only on the downstream side of the dam.
According to the American Cancer Society, more than 10,000 people in Texas will die due to lung cancer this year. To reduce these numbers, the Cancer Society has declared today the Great American Smokeout. Smokers are urged not to smoke for at least the day, or for longer if they can. The Texas State Student Health Center is doing its part around campus, posting reminders and handing out information in the quad. Also, the Health Center offers a smoking cessation program for faculty, staff, and students for a nominal fee.
The Texas State Sleep Lab is hosting Sleepless in San Marcos, a public information forum on sleeping difficulty. Anyone suffering from sleep-related difficulties, including morning headaches, snoring, and staying focused, are encouraged to attend the forum tonight at 7 o'clock. Sleep disorders can cause multiple health-related problems. These problems can be resolved when restorative sleep is made possible through treatment. The Sleep Lab at Texas State is state-of-the-art and designed to diagnose as well as treat sleep disorders. Physicians and sleep specialists will present information on sleep disorders and answer any questions related to the topic.
Coming up on Bobcat Update, we'll tell you about the Bobcats and the Bearcats big matchup this weekend. Stick around.
The San Marcos Police Department provides a wealth of information for citizens. Citizens have access to information about programs run by officers, press releases, and accident reports. This information can be accessed from anywhere on the SMPD website.
On our website, we try to maintain information that we believe the public will find useful. We have some links to our public presentations where each 6 months we update the people of San Marcos on recent crime trends and crime patterns and statistics, some interesting cases we've worked on, some of our plans for the future. You can find all that on the website.
To get to the police department website, go to the city's webpage, click on departments, scroll down and click police. You can access information from the police department or the city's website by going to www.ci.san-marcos.tx.us.
The Texas State Bobcats have the opportunity to go undefeated at home for the first time since the early 1980s. Saturday afternoon at 3 o'clock, the Bobcats are set to host rival Sam Houston State at Bobcat Stadium. A win on Saturday could better their chances of earning a bid in the Division I AA playoffs. Much of Texas State's destiny lies on the Nichols State field. The Colonels, who are currently sharing the Southland Conference lead with the Bobcats, host McNeese State this weekend. If the Colonels win, they will earn the automatic playoff berth, and Texas State would hope to receive one of the 8 at-large Division I AA playoff bids.
Only 5 days are left to drop a class this semester. Here's AJ LeBron with more in this Bobcat update.
The end of the semester is fast approaching, and with it comes many decisions for students, like whether or not to drop a class. This Monday at 5 p.m. is a deadline for students wanting to make such a change. The university has made it simple for students who wish to withdraw from a course.
It was really easy. I just wrote an email to my professor, asked them what I needed to do. They told me to come in, talk to them in person, and then I just got on the internet after they told me whether my grade was going to be a W or an F. And I was able to get on Cat's Web and drop it.
Students can drop a course until Monday with a W or a WF. Dropping a course with a W means that the student will not be penalized on his or her GPA. However, in order to drop the course with a W, the student must be passing. If the student is not passing and wishes to drop, then he or she may receive a WF, which basically means an F will be given to the student for the course. Students should talk to the professor before dropping a course to see if there are any other alternatives.
Each instructor has different policies with that. The university policy would say that if the student has a failing grade, then an WF would be an acceptable policy, but each instructor can modify that policy based on their own requirements.
For students who want to drop a course, you only have a few days left before the deadline passes this Monday. To drop a course, you can log on to Cat's Web, or for more information, you can talk to your academic advisor. For Bobcat Update, I'm AJ LeBron.
Thanksgiving is almost upon us, and many students are planning to hit the highway and head home. Classes will not meet Wednesday, and the dorms will close that night, sending hundreds of students onto the roadways. Most dining halls will begin closing Tuesday night, but Chick-fil-A and the LBJ Student Center will remain open until 1 on Wednesday afternoon. The dormitories will reopen at noon on Sunday, and dining halls will be back to their regular schedule Monday morning. Now, traffic is historically busy during the holiday weekend, so the university is encouraging its students to keep safety in mind on your trip.
For many students, a big feast will await them when they go home for the holidays. There's turkey and dressing and desserts and so much more. It'll be a time to eat and eat a lot. Dietitians estimate that some people consume 3,000 or more calories when they sit down for a Thanksgiving meal. If you're concerned at all about your weight, you need to consider what it'll take to burn off those calories. Health officials say 4 hours of running or 5 hours of swimming or 30 miles of walking ought to do it. Well, we hope that each of you will take the safety very serious over the holidays and have a great Thanksgiving. I'm LaShamba Randall.
And I'm Michael S. We'll see you next time.